So yes, where is it? Yes, here it is. So good afternoon, friends. We have started with transistor as a switch in the last class, right? So we were working for the unregulated power supplies, where we were expecting that how a transistor is going to play a vital role in these unregulated power supplies. But before that, we will start with a very small device that we call it as the Zener diode, which is used in reverse bias and which is a most important component of regulated power supplies. So that is where we will be starting today. So we'll be working on the regulated power supplies. We have studied this, how we use a AC input and then for a rectifier, then it is given to a filter, and then we will be giving it to the voltage regulator, right? So we have done this up till now, and then we have to start with the Zener diode as a voltage regulator. Now, what is how a Zener diode works as a voltage regulator? So Zener diode is to be used in reverse bias. This is a circuit diagram. Sorry, I'm also going to tell you how we will be solving this equation, and we'll be looking at how a Zener diode can be used as a voltage regulator, right? So here what I have done is I have given an input DC voltage, which is supposed to be the unregulated one and which is going to vary from, say, 80 volt to 100 volt, right? And it is given to a Zener diode, which has a voltage rating of 50 volt, which means that at this two points, it is going to store 50 volts, right? And after that, at the last, we have a parallel load resistance across this Zener diode. So that is of 10 kilo ohms. So if you are able to see over here, okay, if you are able to see over here, this is a simple connection, and we have connected a series resistance, the voltage across which is going to be the VR. Voltage across the resistance, series resistance, is VR. The total current that is going to flow is I. That current, total I current, which is going to divide into two parts according to Kirchhoff's current law. And it is going to divide into, say, two portions. That is, one is IZ, that is through the Zener diode. And the other one is the load current that is going through the load resistance RL, right? So here it is, the circuit is like this. Now we are having two types of regulations. As I told you earlier, there are two types of regulations, the line regulation and the load regulation, right? So line regulation implies that whenever there is a drift or whenever there is a change in the input side voltage, V in voltage, then there is supposed to change, that is supposed to change the output voltage, right? So if you are able to control this, then we will call it as a line regulation. On the second part, when we are expecting that load regulation. So when this RL is going to change, the output voltage is also going to change, right? So during that time also, we are expected to control the output voltage. So we are having two types of regulation. The first one is the line regulation, in which the input voltage is supposed to change and accordingly the output voltage is going to change, right? And on the second part, we are going to work on the load resistance side, where the load resistance is going to change. That means the current, that is the load current, is going to change, and accordingly we have to control the output voltage. So on both the sides we are going to work. Now how this Zener diode is going to work as an voltage regulator circuit, right? So for that, we are having these three equations which are written on the top of the slide. That is VO, that is the output voltage, should be equal to V in minus VR. So the total output voltage should remain constant. That is the main purpose of understanding this Zener diode as a voltage regulator. So output voltage, that is equal, that must be equal to the V in minus VR. So according to, say, the potentials of, say, the, sorry, Kirchhoff's voltage law, this is there. So the total output voltage that is over here shall be the summation of the input voltage as well as the voltage drop across the resistance, the series resistance over here. So VO must be equal to Vin minus VR. That is the formula. Now, as for the current and current, Kirchhoff's current law, if you are able to see over here that the I is like I must be equal to IZ plus IL, right? So IZ plus IL is over there. That is IZ, that is the Zener current, must be equal to the total current minus IL. So this is the these are very important formulas. I hope you should write those formulas. Now here, in the next we will try some take cases in which we are expecting the input voltage, that is the V in, is going to change, and accordingly how the Zener diode is going to regulate the output voltage, right? So for that, the first one is the line regulation. So we'll move to that. So in the first is the same circuit we are going to use, and in which we are expecting that the input voltage is going to vary from 80 to 100 volt. The Zener diode is of 50 volt. We are expecting the output voltage to be constant at 50 volt. So we have used the Zener diode for 50 volt. The voltage across the resistance is taken as VR. The current flowing through the whole circuit is capital I, whereas it is being divided into two parts, that is IL and IZ. IL is flowing through this load resistance, that is 10 kilo ohms. And IZ is the current that is going to flow through the Zener diode, right? So over this, so the first case, in first case, what happens, we will consider that the IL should be equal to say 50 volts. So output voltage divided by RL will give you the load current, and by this formula, if you put 50 volts divided by 10 kilo ohms, then the load current should be equal to 5 milliampere. So this must be the first equation for that. So now initially we are assuming that the current that is going to flow through the load resistance should be equal to 5 milliampere, right? So in the second case, let us see that since Vin is going to vary from 80 to 100. So we are considering the first case, that let it be 80 volts. So if it is 80 volts, then output voltage should be equal to 50 volt. The drop of 30 volts must be across the resistance, series resistance R. So VR must be equal to 30 volts in this case. So that can be calculated by using VR is equal to 80 volt minus 50, that is equal to 30 volts. So that is what we are putting it in equation 2. I expect from your side that you should keep writing on this so that you will be able to understand what we are trying to do. And we are trying to maintain the output voltage across the Zener diode or across the load resistance RL. So the total drop of 30 volts should be across this series resistance, right? So in the next, by Ohm's law, the current through R now will be equal to I equal to VR. So the current through this resistance, series resistance R, should be equal to VR by R, that is equal to 30 volt by 5 kilo ohms. Now this resistance which we are using here is 5 kilo ohms. So it must be equal to 6 milliamperes, right? So the 6 milliampere current should flow through, the total current should flow from this resistance, that the I should be equal to 6 milliampere. But the IL should be equal to say 5 milliamperes. So now Zener current is calculated from that equation, equation number 1 and equation number 3. If you subtract it, so you will get the Zener current. Now I is equal to IZ by IL, that is IZ must be equal to I minus IL. So I is now 6 milliamperes. The total current flowing through this load resistance, that is IL, is equal to 5 milliampere, and the current that should flow from the Zener diode should be equal to 1 milliampere. Sorry. So 1 milliampere should be the current flowing through the Zener diode. If 1 milliampere current flows through this Zener diode, then the output voltage will remain at 50 volts. So now we have, when Vin equal to 80 volt, this is the first case that I am putting in front of you. If Vin when V in is equal to 80 volt, VR should be equal to 30 volt. VO, that is output voltage, should be equal to 50 volts. And the the Zener current, that is IZ, should be equal to 1 milliampere, right? But the output voltage remains constant. So it is 50 volt. Now let us consider the second case in which I am trying to tell you that let the current increases from, say, 80 volt to 100 volt. Now what happens if it increases to 100 volt? The output voltage should remain constant, that is 50 volt. So the other 50 volt, that should drop across the series resistance, right? So that series resistance can be, the voltage across that series resistance can be calculated as VR equal to Vin minus VO. The same equation is over there. So now the voltage has been increased from 80 to 100, which implies that 100 minus 50 volt, the voltage across the series resistance should be equal to 50 volt, right? Now the current is also going to change. So VR by R, that is 50 volt by 5 kilo ohms, should be equal to 10 milliamperes. Now, what should be the amount of current that should flow through the Zener diode? Again, that can be calculated by using IZ equal to I minus IL, right? So IL is constant since the output voltage is constant. Therefore, if we minus subtract this, so IZ is equal to I minus IL, that is 10 milliampere minus 5 milliampere equal to 5 milliampere, right? So now the Zener current will increase from 1 milliampere to 5 milliamperes. And subsequently, the output voltage will remain constant. So that is shown over here. And this is there. So now the output voltage is 50 volts. Load current is 5 milliamperes. Zener current is 5 milliampere. So the excess of 5 milliampere is being flown through the Zener diode, and the output load resistance, through the load resistance, the current remains constant, right? So again, let us say that it increases, the voltage also increases from, say, now 110 to again, 100 to 110. So again, the same sort of equations we have to follow. So we have to calculate the voltage across the resistance. Now in this case, the voltage across the series resistance should be equal to 60 volts, right? And if we calculate the current through that Zener diode, that is the total current, that is I equal to VR by R, and it will give you 60 by 5 kilo ohms, that is equal to 12 milliampere. Since the current through the load resistance remains constant, that is 5 milliamperes, so the current which is flowing through the Zener diode, that can be changed. So now IZ can be calculated again by the same equation, that is I minus IL, that is 12 milliamperes minus 5 milliamperes. So we are going to get 7 milliamperes. So now the total current that is going to flow in this case, case 3, that through the Zener diode is now 7 milliamperes, right? Likewise, if you plot a diagram like this, so we will be able to see that when the V in voltage increases from 80 volt, 100 volt, and to 110 volt, accordingly, the voltage across the resistance also increases from 30 volt, 50 volt to 60 volt. Right, and the current, that is the total current, also increases from 6 milliamperes, 10 milliamperes, and to 12 milliamperes. IZ current should increase, whereas IL and VO should remain constant, and indirectly it will keep the output voltage and the load current as constant. So if you are able to see over here, we are now drawing attention, when the input voltage is 80 volt, the voltage across the series resistance is 30 volt, the current, total current flowing through the circuit is 6 milliamperes, the total current flowing through the IZ is equal to 1 milliampere, the total current through load resistance is 5 milliamperes, whereas the output voltage remains constant at 50 volts. So IL and output voltage remains constant throughout, and the voltage across the series resistance and the the current through the series resistance varies, and accordingly it keeps the output voltage to constant. This is how a Zener diode can be used as a voltage regulator when the input voltage, that is the line, is being changing. So this is how a Zener diode works as a voltage regulator. We will repeat this for you. So yes, students, we have started with this. We have started with this unregulated power supplies, and here unregulated power supplies, we are trying to work on Zener diode as a voltage regulator. In that, we have tried to make a circuit like this. Zener diode is always used in reverse bias, and a proper voltage Zener diode is being employed over there, and accordingly this is being used. So in this circuit, if you are able to see, input voltage is being given over here parallelly. It has a series resistance R that is having the value of say 5 kilo ohms, right? And now we have connected a parallel resistance Zener diode. Now in every circuit we are going to use this Zener diode in the parallel. It is always used in reverse bias, right? So this is over there. Then this Zener diode is of 50 volt. Then across the same lines, across the Zener diode, at the output voltage, we are using a load resistance of 10 kilo ohms. So there is a division of this current, that is total I is flowing through the circuit, and it is being divided into two portions, IZ and IL. And the voltage is also divided by voltage, Kirchhoff's voltage laws. So this is VR, and the voltage across the Zener diode is equal to the output voltage, VU. So over there, this is the circuit. And now the important equations that we have to keep in mind while solving this is output voltage should be equal to Vin minus VR. So that is the total voltage Vin, which is given to the circuit, is divided into two portions. That is the voltage drop across the resistance, that is VR, and the output voltage VO. So VO must be equal to Vin minus VR, or indirectly you can say Vin must be equal to VO plus VR. So VR plus VO will give you the total input voltage, right? So VO is equal to Vin minus VR. This is one equation. Then for the second equation, for current, that is Kirchhoff's current law, the total current I is divided into two portions, that is IZ and plus IL, right? IZ plus IL. That is, we can say that we can again equate it to IZ is equal to I minus IL, right? So this is the equation over there. We are trying for the first case in which we are expecting that the input line, the line voltage is being unregulated, and accordingly the output voltage should be maintained at a particular voltage. So it is to be regulated. Now therefore, what we are trying to do here is we are having a case that in this we are varying the voltage from 80 to 110 volts, and we are expecting the output voltage to remain at 50 volts. For that, we are studying here, this is the case which is called as the line regulation, in which the input voltage is supposed to vary and the output voltage should remain constant. So this is there. So in the first case, what we have done is we have started with that the input voltage, let it be say 80 volts. Since we are expecting the output voltage to be constant, so it should be 50 volts. So the net, the drop of that voltage, that is say 30 volt, should drop across the series resistance, that is R. So we can calculate that by this formula, that is VR is equal to Vin minus VO, that is 80 volt minus 50 volt, and that comes out to be 30 volt. So 30 volts voltage should drop across the series resistance, that is VR. So this is equation number two. Now the second case, now this is by Ohm's law, the current through the resistance R can be calculated, that is the total current, that is I must be equal to VR divided by R. That is a simple Ohm's law equation. So I must be equal to VR by R, and that is equal to 30 volt, that is the drop across the resistance, should be divided by the value of that resistance, that is now we are using 5 kilo ohms resistance. So that comes out to be say 6 milliamperes. So the total current, that is this I, is 6 milliamperes. We require that 5 milliampere should go through the load resistance RL, and the rest of that should go through the Zener diode. So that can be calculated by this equation. Now Zener current IZ can be calculated like I must be equal to IZ plus IL, as I told you. Therefore, IZ is equal to I minus IL, and that is equal to 6 milliamperes, that is total current minus the 5 milliampere, which is supposed to be across the load resistance. So 5 milliamperes current. So the total current comes out to be through IZ comes out to be 1 milliampere. Thus, when Vin equal to 80 volt, VR must be, that is the voltage across the resistance, series resistance R, must be equal to 30 volt. Output voltage must remain constant at 50 volt. IZ should change to 1 milliampere, and IL should remain also to 5 milliamperes, right? So this was the first case. In the second case, what we have done is we have increased the voltage, say from 80 volt to 100 volt now. So VR is going to change. So VR is going to change now from, say, 100 minus 50, that is equal to 50 volts, right? So I is also going to change. So I will be equal to VR by R, that is equal to 50 volt by 5 kilo ohms. And now the total current comes out to be 10 milliampere. So what it means, what it implies is that the Zener current is going to flow, the Zener current that should be equal to 5 milliamperes, that should flow through the Zener diode, and the rest of 5 milliamperes should flow through the load resistance so that the output voltage should remain constant, right? So here we are able to calculate that IZ is equal to I minus IL, that is 10 milliampere minus 5 milliampere, and that's that comes out to be, say again, 5 milliamperes. So this is this is the equation for the second case. Now for this third case, when we are again increasing that voltage, say from 100 to 110 volt, now indirectly it's going to increase the voltage across the series resistance. That is, VR must be equal to Vin minus VO, that is 110 minus 50 volt, that is 60 volts. So the total current that is to flow from the, that is to be flowing from the circuit, should be equal to 60 volt by 5 kilo ohms, that is 12 milliamperes, and the Zener current, that is I minus IL, should be equal to 12 milliampere minus 5 milliampere, and that comes out to be 7 milliamperes. So this is how the output voltage remains constant, and that can be again shown by this table. That does, when Vin will increase to 110, Zener current, Zener will take excess current of 7 milliamperes through it, and it will keep the output voltage 50 volt as constant. This is known as the line regulation, and this is a table which is going to show you that how the Zener diode is working as an voltage regulator circuit during the line regulation part, right? So if you are able to see over here, input voltage is going to vary like 80 volt, 100 volt, and 110 volt, whereas the voltage drop across the series resistance, that is VR, is also changing 30 volt, 50 volt, and 60 volt depending on the input voltage, indirectly keeping the output voltage as constant to 50 volts. Similarly, the current across the low Zener diode is also varying, as you are able to see over here, that IZ is increasing from 1 milliampere, 5 milliampere, and 7 milliampere respectively, as the voltage Vin increases from 80, 100, and 100 and 110 volts respectively. So the IL and output voltage will remain always constant, and this is how the in line regulation, even if the line voltage varies accordingly, the Zener voltage is going to keep the output voltage as constant, and the load current which is supposed to flow through this resistance will also maintain at 5 milliamperes only, right? So I hope this will be enough for you. Now in the next class we are going to study about, say, the load regulations, and in that again we will try to use different sorts of loads, and in that we will again try to solve this as in an equation, like, so that the voltage should remain constant. I hope you have understood this. So this was the circuit that I was expecting to tell you, that this is a circuit of a Zener voltage regulator, Zener diode as a voltage regulator, and Zener diode is always used in reverse bias, in which I hope you have got this, that Zener diode regulates the output voltage to a constant voltage. Since this Zener diode used over here is of 50 volts, which implies that it is going to keep the output voltage, voltage across the Zener diode itself as 50 volt as constant. So whatever voltage you want to regulate, if you want to regulate a 12 volt power supply, then you have to use a 12 volt Zener diode. This is what is to be kept in mind always, right? Hello. So this is the equation. I hope you have understood this. And if you have not understood, you can chat it on chat box. Even you can put it on the WhatsApp group, right? I'm also uploading this videos on, say, my YouTube channel. I request you all to kindly go through that YouTube channel. And also, okay, now see the attendance is being decreased. So I'll take this. Yes. So I request you all to kindly go through that channel, like those channels, and keep on viewing this videos, because these are going to help you. On YouTube, what happens? On YouTube, you are able to repeat those videos, so that if anything is being missed out over there, you are able to again repeat those videos and see on yourself, right? So I expect many more students to come over here, but the attendance is decreasing. So mind this, I'm going to give this last, yes, you can unmute yourself and ask questions. Right. If you have any questions. Okay, somebody has put. No problem, sir. Thank you, Samiksha, for that. So friends, thank you. Thank you very much for joining me. Stay at home, stay safe, and be healthy. Take care of yourself and your family. Have a nice time. Take care. See you tomorrow again. Bye. Have a nice day, sir.